alum, and I'm back now with the show. Let's talk about fun stuff, girls and lakes, summertime.
We can come to girls in a moment, don't you worry. You know me, I'll get to the girls. But let's talk politically. You're a fascinating creature, politically, because you're pro-gay marriage. And stop me if I get this wrong. You're pro-choice when it comes to abortion. You're pro-guns, though, on that side of the debate. We'll talk about that in a moment. You supported Obama in 08. You actually performed his inauguration. Then you switched to Romney. How would you describe where you are politically now?
I'm pretty confused, still. I don't know, but I just, I've always tried not to be so vocal about it, because it always, when I see celebrities talking about it, I'm just like, oh, man, stop talking. And of course, what am I doing up there? Like, oh, Romney. But, I don't know. You grow, you learn, people seem to be interested in what you have to say. I don't know. I'm sure some people are. I'm sure the majority aren't,
Why did you give up on Obama?
Just the whole way things were going with that, especially just separating the country even more. It seems like it was a time when everyone should really have been coming together over such a great thing.
Was that his fault?
Someone's got to take the blame. It's always the guy at the top. We have a bad show, my guitar player screws it up. No one says, oh, the guitar player screwed it up. So Kid Rock sucked up.
Right.
Just got to make
sure. I know that feeling.
Yeah.
But every night with my producers. Let's go through some of these things. On the gay rights, gay marriage thing, are you from the you couldn't really give a damn category?
I don't care. I'm Catholic. I really don't think it's right, because I think a man and a woman and creating a child, there's something to be said for that. If people are going to make this much of a stink over it, we got much more problems. We got way bigger problems. I'm conflicted with internally how I feel myself with it, but, if you want to get married, go for it.
You see, I have no problem with that.
I like to joke that everyone should be able to be miserable.
pro-choice is interesting. Mm-hmm. There aren't many Republicans who would be pro-choice.
I just think it's a woman's right.
Full stop.
It's very touchy, but I think at the end of the day, it's got a fault in women.
Guns. You are pro-guns? Are you in favor of any gun control?
The only thing I could think of that might work, no, I'm not for gun control. At this point, it's a long conversation, but I'll give you one thing I thought of. I was actually thinking this today. I thought you might bring this up. is maybe as family, this comes back to family structure. I know someone in my family who probably should have assault weapons or, big guns. Maybe they should have a home protection if they want it, but that's it. So maybe as a family member, I should get like my mom, my dad, maybe an uncle. Maybe there should be four or five of us to flag him.
What?
A flagger. So when he goes in and tries to get this gun, he's been flagged by his family. You know what I mean? And then he has to go through something to be evaluated. We're really talking about mental health, right? At the end of the day, is what I feel. We're talking about mental health.
Do you own a lot of guns or something?
Yes.
Would you consider yourself to be safe with
them? Yes.
Why do you trust 315 million other Americans to be fully safe with them? Why do you feel comfortable that...
Because I got one.
Simple as that. You need to have one for protection.
I need to have one. When I go to Detroit, I never go to Detroit without my gun. Ever. Right by my side. Loaded, ready.
And you wouldn't hesitate to use it?
No. Not at all.
But is that healthy for a society? Especially a superpower.
It's not healthy. It's just the way it is. It's like getting into a conversation about racism. Is it done because we got a black president? No. It's always going to be here. We have to just learn better ways to deal with it. Now, everyone needs to calm down. Let's calm down and see these tragedies slow down and try to learn something more about it than just, finding a henchman or something.
But it's easy to say calm down. What if you're one of the families from Sandy Hook?
Well, I think there's families on both sides from what I've read. There's families that are we've got control guns more, and there's families that that's not
true. Right, it's true.
So, like I said, I think there's a conversation to be had. An open and honest one, which seems like they don't have too many of these days in America.
It's very different compromise, isn't it?
Yeah, people get so up in arms and get so hell-bent one way or the other. It's like, when I did the Romney thing, so many people got their panties in a bunch. And as a musician, as a rock and roll musician, you want to find ways to piss people off. I found it when people got upset. I'd have gotten to politics years ago. It makes people so upset. I'm like, but at the end of the day, really, it's like, come on, it's okay to have a different viewpoint than to voice it.
You met Obama after he won again, yeah. And Romney had lost. Did he have a little joke at your expense?
He was cool. I've always said this about Obama and Obama. He was cool. You know, I've been fortunate enough to pretty much meet all the living presidents. Isn't that what cool and Obama? Actually, people hate that I say George Bush is actually pretty cool, pretty funny guy. But Obama just dropped
out. What did he say to you when he said
I said, you know, I think when I popped up in the receiving line, I was like, he's like, get her on. You're like, hey, man, no hard feelings. He's like, I won. I'm like, no. It's all funny games. I mean, I can't imagine what those guys deal with. Just punching each other in the head, you know, over what their beliefs and this, that, and the other in politics, and then they probably go sit down and have a ham sandwich, you know.
Let's tell you another break. Come back and talk about pot. We haven't discussed legalizing pot. Clint Eastwood and his performance at the Republican convention, where many thought he was on pot.
I thought it was great.